Hi guys, welcome back. I promised this video would be up during Vlogmas the second day, and I told you guys that the footage would not upload from phone to laptop. And one of you all commented and said how to airdrop it, and I did that and it worked. It airdropped, but it went into my QuickTime player and then couldn't figure out how to get it off of that onto my computer to iMovie to edit to post. So here we are refilming it. Now I literally just have my tripod sitting on my bed because the window lighting is behind me. This is like a much more real sit down feeling. Since this is such like a serious video, I kind of like the way this is going. I know I had like 50 minutes of footage from the first time I tried to tell the story, so I'm going to try to trim down the details a little bit more. For those of you that don't know the background, haven't heard me talk about this, I went to New York the first weekend of November. If you're new here, I post every week on Thursday, sometimes like two or three times a week. I did not post at all during the month of November. One of the main reasons I wanted to film this was to explain why I didn't post the whole month, and that was strictly for my own safety purposes. I just did not want to put my life out on YouTube for at least a month because of what happened. I'm making up for it now, doing Vlogmas, posting every day for a month. The main reason I wanted to post this was because of like the awareness, I guess, that it could bring to the table, because I know I feel like most of my viewers, not all, but a lot of you guys are girls, and this is like super serious. And when you hear me tell the story, like when I tell the story, I look back and I'm like, God, how was I that stupid? Like, how did I not see this happening? When you're actually in the moment, like you really don't. So like, I just want to, I don't know, just share my story so that maybe if you ever find yourself in this situation, you can think back and be like, I know what's happening. Like, I need to remove myself from this situation immediately. This is crazy. Like, I never thought I would tell the story on camera just because I don't necessarily want to. I don't want the wrong person to see it. But then again, I feel like it could potentially help someone. So I'm going to tell the story. So if you guys are ready, I've already wasted 3 minutes of time talking about the backstory. So here we go. First weekend of November, the story takes place, New York City. I was there with my mom, my grandmother, two of my best friends, their mom and their grandmother. So the two moms, our moms, were running the New York City Marathon on Sunday. So Saturday night, Alabama was playing LSU, and I wanted to watch. Our moms were going to bed early, and because they were running the marathon the next morning, our two rooms were literally right across the hall from each other, and I had nowhere to watch the game because everyone was going to bed early. My mom was like, why don't you just go watch it in the lobby downstairs, like where the bar is. I'm sure they would turn the game on. So that is what I did. And I went with my friend. I'm gonna say her name's Katie because I don't know if she wants her name out there about this. So we go down and we're watching the game. We're both wearing an Alabama shirt. So this woman walks in. She's pretty. She looks like she's about 30. She was acting drunk. Like I thought she was just drunk. She was so funny though. Like to watch her was almost hilarious. And she is so personable. Like she was just talking to everybody. Just like what you do when you go out. But like this wasn't a real bar. It was just a hotel bar. But she was just being very friendly to everyone. So I'm watching her and she like sits down in front of the TV at the bar and she puts her phone up to it and she's on Facebook Live. She's like recording the game. And I was like, oh, maybe she's a fan. And then like I watch her turn the camera around and I'm on her phone screen. I was like, Katie, look, I'm on this girl's phone. But like at the time I just thought maybe, you know, she's from Alabama or LSU, she's a fan, and then I'm sitting over here acting like an idiot over this game and she's putting me on her Facebook Live, and I was like, no big deal. Then I just completely forgot that that ever happened. Okay, a few minutes later she turns around, she's like, are you guys from Alabama? And we're like, no, we're from Kentucky, I'm just a big Alabama fan, like blah blah blah. She's like, oh, okay, well I was gonna pull for LSU but they suck, so I'll be an Alabama fan with you. And I was like, okay, cool. She just like starts talking to us. She's having like a normal conversation just like you would meet anybody else in a bar, but she's funny because like I genuinely thought she was just really drunk and a little crazy. So we're like enjoying her company because she's funny. She can tell she's kind of getting on my nerves because like I'm trying to watch the game and she's trying to talk to me. So she finally backs off. She's just sitting there by herself. She came by herself. Halfway through the game, this guy walks in and he's like dressed in a nice suit, didn't really catch my attention. And I noticed like the two of them start talking. You could like overhear their conversation, and it was just like basic get to know you conversation. Like she was like, oh, do you like football? Like I could tell like they had just met, I thought. During their conversation, like she turns around, it's like halftime to us, and she's like, hey Bama girl, I was like, how are we doing? I'm like, oh, you know, we're doing better now. That's all she says. And then she like comes back there to show us something on her Facebook that it was just like so pointless. And I was just like, yeah, whatever. Then she goes back to talk to this guy again. Mind you, he never turned around to look at us, which I thought was kind of weird because like normally if someone that you're talking to is talking to someone else, like you're gonna interact in that conversation too. But he wanted nothing to do with us, never looked at us. And then like, I guess in the third quarter, he left. And so whenever he stood up to leave, I could hear her say, oh, when am I ever gonna see you again? So like you could tell like he had implied they were gonna see each other again. He left, and then she comes back to us where we're sitting at our table, and she's like, I just want you guys to know that I really wanted to Kim tonight. I was like, holy TMI. Like, I do not even know you, woman. And you're like 30. Why are you telling me this? But she did. She told me. So I was just like, okay. And she was like, but honestly, what I really wanted to come back here and tell you guys is that I don't know him. And she was like, he seemed like a really nice, respectable guy, but I don't know what he's gonna do to me when he gets me alone. She said, for all I know, he could murder me. And I was thinking, I mean, yeah, you got a point. She's like, he gave me the hotel name that he's staying at and the room number that he's in if I wanna go. But she was like, you never know what people are gonna do when they get you behind closed doors. And I was like, true, okay. She's like going on and on and on, like talking about this. Then she realizes once again, she's getting on my nerves. So she goes and sits back down. Then the game's almost over. There's like 5 minutes left. It's very clear we're gonna win. So I guess she decides to push her luck and come back and talk to us again. She's still alone. No one else in there. It's just her. And she's like back there talking to us. She's talking about this guy again. She called him Mike. She starts talking about like how we're so beautiful. And she's like, I hate being blonde headed and blue eyed. She's like, it's such a target for people. And she was like, you just can't trust anybody. And she's like, you guys are so beautiful. You should never, never go anywhere alone. Like, she's like hinting at all this stuff. And I was just like, not thinking anything of it. Like, I was just thinking, she's one of us. Like, she's in the same situation. Because it's true. It is difficult for like girls to go places alone, especially in places like New York City now. Mind you, like, I don't really know anything about her. So we start talking and we're like, oh, where are you from? Like, what are you doing here? She's like, what are you guys doing here from Kentucky? And we were like, our moms are running the marathon tomorrow. We're here with our grandmothers and her sister. We're telling her all this information. She's like, oh, cool. I'm from Connecticut. And I was like, okay, what are you doing down here? And she's like, I'm just trying to stay out of jail. Huh? And she's like, yeah, my husband's trying to get me thrown in jail. Okay, she gave us the whole backstory. She goes on to tell us that, like, he beats her and he's abusive and all this stuff. So, like, naturally, like, we fall into the conversation. We feel really bad for her. She says that her husband, her son that lives out in California didn't feel safe with her son that lived at home living with the father. So he asked her to leave the dad. I mean, if he beats her, she should have left him anyways. So she says that she tells him that she wants to leave him. And then he goes to the police and says that she threatened to murder him, and then he got her thrown in a psych. So this is when I'm thinking, okay, she's acting like this because she's literally psycho. But at the same time, like, I still enjoyed her. I felt bad for her at this point because, like, oh my gosh, this woman, like, she's had a hard life. Her husband beats her. Like, oh my gosh, I feel so sorry for her. I was like, I mean, I'm just gonna sit here and listen to her talk. So, like, she's telling us this story forever. We get closer. We spend like an hour getting to know her whole life. Like, she tells us everything about her. Mind you, it's like midnight at this point, okay? Asking us like if we have boyfriends and stuff, and she was saying how she would love to hook us up with her sons. That, and she like gets on her Facebook and she's showing us pictures of her family, of her two sons, of her husband. She's showing us all this. So like, naturally, I feel like a friend to her now. Like, even though I'm thinking she's 30, we could be friends. Her kids are definitely older. So I'm like, how old are you? And she's like 54. And I was like, 54? I was like, I thought you were maybe 30, maybe 20. Like, I was 54. Like, guys, she did not look 54. And she's like, no, here, look at my passport. And I was like, okay, why not your ID? But okay, whatever, passport works. So she shows us her passport, like she's 54, telling us how she travels all the time to all these places. And she's like, do you guys speak any different languages? And I'm like, no. Well, so then she goes back to her husband. She's talking about how he's a Christian, but he's not a follower of Christ. And she's giving us a Bible lesson. And she's telling us how she's a Christian, but also not a follower of Christ. And it's just like super weird at this point. And I'm like, ready for bed. Cause it's like after midnight. So then she starts talking about us some more. We've already been talking about us a little bit. Like, she knows what we're there for. She knows where we're from. She knows who we're with. And we've like showed her pictures of our moms and like who we were with and stuff. Cause I mean, I considered her a friend. She's already asked us about school and stuff, and we've told her. And she tells me that she knows a girl that goes to the University of Kentucky, and she pulls up her Facebook and she shows us that. Like, she was a very trustworthy woman, guys. Like, everything was backed up with facts. We start talking about things that are like gonna happen in the future. And every time I would say something like, it's gonna happen, or I'm gonna do this, she'd be like, whoa, 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 back up, wait a minute. Like, it might happen. And I was like, yeah, I guess. Like, I'm pretty sure it's gonna happen, but okay. And she was like, it might happen. And then one time, like, I walked away for a minute, and she asked Katie, the girl I was with, have you known her for a while? And Katie was like, yeah, my whole life. And she was like, I'm really worried about her. She's like, she seems really impulsive. Okay, thanks. But Katie told me that later. She's asking us about school again. And she's like, hold on, hold on, hold on. I can't keep up. Let me write this down. I was like, huh? So, guys, like, in front of our faces where we could see what she was doing, she gets in her backpack, pulls out a notepad, flips the pages a few times, pulls out a pencil, and she starts writing. Jayde, Eastern Kentucky University, elementary education major. She wrote down Katie's name, where Katie goes to school, what Katie's majoring in. And I was like, What are you doing? Why are you doing this? I didn't ask any questions. I still really liked the woman. I thought she was just crazy. I was like, maybe she's just lonely. I did not understand what was happening. Like, I tell you, you listen to this story now, sounds stupid. You live in the story, you just don't really think anything of it. So then, like, this was like the first real red flag we had. And then from here on out, the story just goes downhill. Katie started coughing and she was like, oh my god, let me go get you some water. So she like runs over to the bar and gets Katie a glass of water. And I'm like watching her because, like, you know, I mean, I didn't really expect her to drug it or anything, but I was like just making sure she didn't. If I would have been Katie, I probably wouldn't have drank the water, just because, like, after she wrote the information down, I was a little sketched out, but I still trusted her. And Katie drank the water anyways, and it was fine, thank god. So I don't know if that was like a way of her trying to get us to trust her. As we're talking, like, we're telling her more about us and like our lives and stuff. Probably almost 1 o'clock in the morning at this point. As we're talking, like, her head is going, it's just looking out the window, and like the window looked out into Times Square. And so Katie like turned around once with her. I was not even noticing that she was doing that, but apparently she was. So like when she looked, Katie looked, she was like, oh, sorry, am I making you nervous looking out the window like that? She was like, I just like look off into the distance when I talk to people sometimes. I mean, I wasn't nervous. Like, I did not even think anything of it. She brought the attention to it, and then it was weird. And then I was like, is someone out there? Like, are you waiting on something? So that was like the second red flag. You know, she's already told us she's got a friend in Kentucky and she's coming to visit her in a couple of months, and she's like, I should get your all's numbers if you're ever up here, like we can hang out, blah blah blah, maybe we can go watch your mom's together in the marathon tomorrow, all this stuff. I'm like, yeah, sure, like I'll give you my number. Don't know why I thought that would be a good idea. But then she puts her phone on the counter, she pulls up contacts, and then she gets out of contacts, and I'm watching her do this, and then she goes to Facebook. I'll just add you guys on Facebook. And I was like, okay. So guys, we've never ever gave her our last names. Like, I promise, that is a fact. And she goes to type in Katie's name, and she types in Katie and her last name. And we both looked up at each other and we were like, we did not give her our last names, guys. I don't know how she knew that. She's like, I can't find you. Like, maybe you should just add me. So we were like, well, what do we do now? Say no. So we added her. And, like, on her Facebook account, she looked 54. But in person, she didn't. I mean, she was definitely the same person, but she looked older. So I added her on Facebook. We sit there and talk to her for 20 more minutes. And then we're both just, like, officially a little bit sketched out and ready for bed. So we were like, we need to get away. We didn't really want to go up to the room just because I was afraid she was being so protective over us. She even said, the reason I didn't go home with Mike is because I wanted to stay here with you guys and make sure that you were okay. You're not my mom. I'm literally in the lobby of my hotel. We decide we're gonna go to the bathroom in the lobby, and we're thinking that'll be how we get away from her, and then we can go to the room. Katie said, I have to pee, and she was like, oh yeah, we'll go to the bathroom. And I was like, oh. On the way to the bathroom, there's like a big poster, and it was for the marathon that people took pictures in front of. And she walks up to it and she's like, oh, let me take your all's picture in front of this, and you can send it to your mom. They'll love it. I was like, no, I don't really want my picture taken. And then it clicked in my head, and I was like, she took a picture. Before she ever spoke to us, she took a picture of me. Like, I'm on her phone. And now she's trying to take another picture of me. So now I'm freaked out. So then, like, it's very obvious that she's wasting time, that she's stalling for some reason. So she walks on over to the poster and she starts like posing in front of it. Here, like, we could take one like this, or one like this. And I was like, no, like, I really don't want my picture. I said, if you want me to take one of you, I will, but I'm not taking one. She's trying to kill time. So we walked to the back of the hotel where the bathroom was, and there's a security guard back there. And she's like, excuse me, sir, can you tell me where the bathroom is? And he's like, yeah, it's right up that ramp to the left. So, like, you could go up the ramp and keep going straight. You could go up the ramp and go to the right, and there were stairs, or you could go up the ramp and go to the left, and there was a sign that said restrooms. So we walk up the ramp, and she starts going up these stairs, and we were like, he said it was to the left. And she's like, no, I'm pretty sure he says up the steps. And I was like, that sign says restrooms. So that was another red flag. What's up those steps that she's trying to get me up there for? Well, she comes right down the stairs and we go to the bathroom. To get into the bathroom, you have to use your hotel key. So she used hers. She swaps it. We go in and Katie goes in the stall. The woman, she's like, I just love the security here at this hotel. She's like, it's so safe. But I'm gonna stand outside just to make sure, like, no creepy men get inside. So then I'm officially like, we're gonna open this bathroom door and there's gonna be men standing there and they're going to kidnap us and they're going to take us. I was like, that's what's happening. I'm ready to open this door and fight for my life. Like, I was expecting it. So Katie texts me. I'll insert the picture. We thought that was the end. So I'm like, oh, I don't have to pee either, so I'll stand out there with you. She doesn't go out there. She comes back in the bathroom. We hightail it out of the bathroom. The only option is to go to the room. In order to get on these elevators, you have to press the floor that you're going to, and then it tells you which elevator to get on. So I let her put hers in first, and she put 15, and we were on 14. They put us on the same elevator, and we ride it up, and I gave her a hug. I was like, good night. Like, I've had so much fun getting to know you. Like, hope to see you again. We literally, guys, get off the elevator, and both of our phones go off. Says, I'm gonna make up a name for her. Hannah is waving at you. Then we get another message, and she's messaging both of us. And I'll just put all the screenshots on the screen. We walk onto the room, we're standing outside, we're talking about it, and I'm like, you know, like, I hate to do this because she was so nice. Just in case, like, there was just too many weird things. We should probably block her. So we do. We block her, and then I'm like, okay, good night. So we're like, we're ready to go in our two different rooms. Katie's key doesn't work, and we both knew. I said, is there any way you had it, like, near your phone that could have deactivated it? And she's like, no, I sat it on the table so that didn't happen. And we were both like, she switched the key right in front of us, and we didn't notice. We were like, maybe not. Like, maybe it just deactivated. So Katie knocks on the door. We both go to bed. So I did not know what happened after that until the next night. So the next morning, our moms get up to run the marathon. I go with my grandmother for the day. Katie and her sister and their grandmother go for the day. We don't see each other. So we just kind of brushed off the whole situation. We're like, haha, tonight we're going to tell you guys about this crazy woman we met last night. Like, the story is so funny. At dinner after the marathon, when we all sat down, we were like, okay, we're going to tell you guys the full story. So we told them basically everything that I just told you, but more. They were so pissed. They were like, you guys are so stupid. She's obviously working for somebody. She's obviously, that's so sex trafficking. I can't believe you didn't pick up on that. Blah, blah. I can't believe you drank the water. Going off on us. I was like, I promise. Like, she seemed so harmless. She was so nice. My mom texted someone. I'm not going to say who because I don't know if this woman's going to watch it or not. And I don't want to get any names thrown out under the bus. But my mom texted someone she knew could find out information about this woman. Literally, like, 10 minutes later, she gets a text message. Her face, guys, was like pale white. We were all like, what? So she shows it to me, and this person found out that, you don't have to believe me, but it's true, that the woman that I literally spent 5 hours with sharing all of my information, like the only thing this woman doesn't know about me is my social security number, is on the FBI's most wanted list. Now, like, when I say most wanted, I'm not sure the depth of that, but she is on the FBI list. I don't know. The whole situation to me was just, like, mind-boggling. This is when Katie decides to tell the part of the story that I didn't know that no one knew. I was already crying because I'm like, oh my God, she knows everything. Katie's like, okay, so last night when my key didn't work, I took a shower, and when I got out of the shower, the door to the hotel room was cracked. I was like, how did you go to sleep? Like, obviously she knew her mom would have ran the marathon if she said anything, and that was the whole reason we went to New York. Kind of understand. And she's put the lock on the door. So that clarified that she switched our keys, and she's obviously known what floor we were on, and she just went by and tried the key on all the doors until it worked. And the only thing we could think was she's tried it, it's worked. She didn't want it to slam back, so she just cracked it. We were like, immediately we left dinner, went back to the hotel. I told the security guard the whole story, and he got us new room keys, and he walked us up to our room to like check them and make sure nobody was in there, and nothing was gone. So like, I still don't know why she came in there or like what her plan was with the key, but she knew we weren't leaving till Monday night, and this was just Sunday. But instead of going into detail about everything that happened next, I'm gonna start wrapping this up because the main point of the story and the awareness is out. I ended up having to talk to the main head of security. I asked him to go back and run the cameras. I wanted to see who was at the top of the steps. We wanted to see her get in the room. We wanted to see all this stuff. And it turns out that in New York, it's against the law to have cameras in the bathrooms, up the steps, in the hallways, on the floors where the rooms are, because NBA players and stuff like apparently cheat on their wives, and it can be like a lawsuit or whatever. That's what we were told. We had to file a report. It was messy, all this stuff. I don't want to get into that for halfway safety reasons, halfway because it's just kind of unnecessary, but like, that was a process. And basically, I just told him, I was like, okay. I was like, she gave out hint after hint after hint about sex trafficking. I was, is it possible that she just really liked us and wanted us to get away? And he was like, there's no way. There's too much money in that. Two scenarios. One, she thought we really trusted her because up until the minute that elevator door shut, it really seemed like we did. And she thought she had a chance. Tomorrow, you saw, like, the next day, you saw the messages, like, she said, go watch our moms at the marathon together and stuff. It would seem a lot easier to, like, kidnap two grown girls, I guess, out in the streets of New York, possibly call us an Uber to go to the marathon, and then, of course, it not be an Uber, rather than, like, try to get us out of the hotel room kicking and screaming. He told us, I 100% know for a fact that if you would have walked outside of this hotel with her, you would not be here. He was like, you're very lucky to be here anyways, but if you would have went outside with her, you wouldn't been. He also made it very clear that the guy that walked in that was in the suit, Mike, was with her. That was all part of the plan. Second scenario, her job is done. She did everything she needed to do, and she got all the information that she needed to get. There's someone else out there that basically is going to kidnap you. And I was like, great. So that seemed like the more likely reason if there's that much money in it that she wouldn't have let us go. So it's been a month now and I'm still here, and I feel so lucky because like of how bad the situation could have been. Like, the guy told me, he was like, you know, when you go back to school, being on college campus, you need to be really careful. These people, he said, this is New York City, and I know you don't worry about that as much in Kentucky. And I'm sitting here thinking in the back of my mind, are you kidding me? I hear stories about this all the time. He was like, these people work together all over the world. But since it's been a month, I feel like it's okay to talk about. I try to take into consideration that even though we blocked her on Facebook, we still had her as a friend for like an hour probably. So if someone else had her password, they could have logged in, got whatever information they needed to know. Even though we had her blocked on Facebook, she blocked Katie's mom. And this was like 2 days after we got home. Katie's mom looked her profile up again and she was blocked from it. And she was like, well, obviously she's went and found me and blocked me. And there's no way she would have been able to find her without had already having her off of our profile. And then like 2 more days after that, Katie's mama sent us a text that said, hey, Hannah, what did I call her? Hannah Haley just added me on Facebook. So we were like, obviously she's not done with whatever she started because she's still tampering with our families. I'm hoping that it's over, and I'm really, really, really hoping that she or the wrong person does not see this video. I hope that you can take a lesson out of this, and I definitely took a big lesson out of it. Like, I'm the most trusting person. This was like a big eye-opener for me that you literally can't trust everybody. It's crazy, and I tried to like dim it down and make it not seem so bad. I left out so many details to make the story shorter, but that's the basic gist of it, and I just wanted to share it with you guys. So this is why I haven't posted in a month, and I hope you guys are careful and safe out there, and I hope you enjoyed this. Even though it's not very like entertaining, it's definitely full of information. I'm gonna end this video now. It's probably like a million minutes long. Thank you guys so much for watching this. I'll see you guys tomorrow in Vlogmas day 4. Bye.